Guess what, Cuse fans? It was another win from Kenny's Two Pennies. Seriously, it was an ugly one at best. But first, a word from our sponsor.
Come to Dewey's Third Ward Tavern. Come to Dewey's. Bridge Street here in Seneca Falls. Bridge Street here in Seneca Falls. Dewey's is the NFL ticket in the NFL network. I'll see you here.
Well, Cuse fans, another win. We're 2-2. We're back at 500 for the first time in about 3 years. Doug Marone seems to be doing a good job. Or is he? I was there in person, section 120 on Saturday, and I saw a lot of good things. Plus, I saw a few things that were troubling. And I'll tell you one of the things that bothered me. What's with the special teams? They weren't special. They were downright ugly. But ugly. Really but ugly. Like me. Two times they go for fake punts and they convert. Two times they go for onside kickoffs and they convert. Just as I said, those were but ugly teams, not special teams like me. Well, anyway, in the first half, it was good to get some of those problems out of the way. Because even though we drove down and scored the first touchdown, that was an ugly touchdown to say the least. First, who knew that Greg Paulus had happy feet? He's running all over the place trying to throw the ball. He's running backwards, sideways, frontwards, whatever. Hey, Mr. Paulus, didn't you ever hear of planting your feet and just delivering the ball? But DeLone Ranger Carter, what's with that juggling act a la the circus in the end zone? First you get thrown the ball, then you juggle it like some clown. And then you fall backward while you're catching it. Who knew this was actually a circus act? Let's hope that's not what this Syracuse team is going to become. And then off of that first onside kick that Maine converts after kicking a field goal, first play after that, they throw a touchdown pass. And you know what? It's a game. 10-7. Drive back down to Ryan Lichtenstein's field goal, or Lichtenstein, however you want to pronounce it, proving he's no Malta, kicking a field goal to tie it at 10. Then again, a fourth down conversion, and what happens? Maine scores another touchdown. And then we drive back down and Lichtenstein showing that he's no Portugal, kicking another field goal, but still at the half. That was one ugly result, 17-13. But finally in the second half, you knew it was Syracuse's will against Maine's. And you know, when that happens, the other team will lose. DeLone Carter, what a breakout game, breakout second half. Three rushing touchdowns. and also one pretty touchdown pass to Marcus Furniture Sales. And finally, Syracuse fans can breathe easy. Although Maine did get a touchdown in garbage time, still, that was a somewhat uneasy win to say the least, and against an FCS team. But Maine was considered one of the scrappier FCS teams. Heck, the one that won the FCS title last year came out of their conference, the Richmond Spiders. Thank God we don't have to play them in football, but still, 41-24, even though we were outgained by about 20 yards by the Black Bears, still was a pretty productive game. 385 yards total offense. Another pretty good day for Paulus passing the ball. And as I said, four touchdowns, three rushing, one receiving for DeLone Ranger Carter. But guys, we had to get those little quirks out of the way, and hopefully our special teams won't be ugly teams. Because now, it's on to the bread of the schedule. And by that I mean the Big East Conference. And we start this Saturday against a bullish team from South Florida. A team that's always beaten up on us in their poor previous meetings. Heck, they've used us for confetti. We've never been able to be close to the Bulls. Although, even with their starting quarterback out because of an ACL injury, B.J. Daniels, who's their backup, stepped right in, leading South Florida to beating Florida State. Kind of shows you that maybe we might be quaking in our boots, or hopefully not. Knowing Doug Marrone, he's going to have us up for these Bulls. But you know what? It's time for the nitty-gritty, Orange fans. Time to get real. The real play begins now. Let's see what this Orange team is made of. And hopefully, it's made of stone. Because that's the way we'll be against these teams. And we'll pound them into the mud. I'm Ken Haas. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Hey, Mr. Paulus, didn't you ever hear of planting your feet and just delivering the ball?